President Yoweri Museveni, who has made a clarion call to young people across the country not to go into activities that sabotage peace in the country, reiterating a strong warning that he will not tolerate any person who makes this country ungovernable. He was speaking as guest of honor at the International Youth Day celebrations that were held at the Kololo Independence Grounds. Let's take a look.
Your Excellency, I would like to thank you and all Ugandans for joining the rest of the world in commemorating this year's International Youth Day.
Uganda today joined the rest of the world to celebrate International Youth Day. Youth in big numbers stand up at Kololo Airstrip for these celebrations, which were held scientifically. President re-echoed the need to keep peace and stability in the country, saying without peace, nothing is tangible.
The first contribution to the youth in Uganda, which everybody should know, is peace and security. This is number one, which the NRM has been able to ensure. And some people wanted to disturb the peace. You saw them last time when we were having elections here. They were actually talking about it. We shall make Uganda ungovernable. Ungovernable. And Yoweri Museveni's leadership. It's a risky undertaking. We shall not tolerate it. We shall crush it. Nobody can make Uganda ungovernable. The youth support peace, all of you. If you hear anybody talking language of Fujo Fujo, tell him off and advise him to stop.
He told the youth leaders to encourage the youth to be productive. Museveni tipped them on four sectors they need to engage in if they are to prosper. These are commercial agriculture, industries, services, and ICT.
The youth will help themselves if everybody understands that you must be youth who are engaged in production. That should be clear. As somebody said, I am a former youth, so I don't need any lectures about youth. I was a productive youth. If you want to help the youth, tell everybody must target to be in the four sectors. If you discover a fifth sector, which I keep forgetting, you tell me. Same Mr. Museveni, there's a sector you forgot.
President Museveni went ahead and asked young people to support free education and do away with what he termed parasites in the education sector. He responded to opposition leader Dr. Kizza Besigye's demand to reopen schools, saying it cannot be risked due to fears of COVID spread.
In terms of empowering the youth, we need to remove money charges from all government schools. The UPE school, they are the schools of the rich. The Buddhas, the what? Those can charge if they want. But for the rural schools and some of the schools in the poor parts of the towns, there should be no charge. In the schools of Kampala, at one time we had compromised that maybe because for them they use electricity, they have water, that maybe the parents could pay for those.
The president promised a wealth fund to benefit the youth in every parish across the country.
Let's put as much money as possible into the wealth funds so that these youth have where to start in case somebody wants to start but has no capital. And I was just my calculator here. I was calculating, if we put like 100 million shillings in each parish, that would be, for 10,000 parishes in Uganda, that would be like 1 trillion. 1 trillion is enough to put 100 million shillings in each parish, where the youth, but also the other people, can go and borrow, do something, pay back. And we can build up this capital if we put 1 trillion each year, 1 trillion, 1 trillion.
The Minister for Gender, Labour and Social Development, Betty Among, The Minister for Gender, Labour and Social Development, Betty Amongi, encouraged young people to engage in agriculture.
There's Easy Agric, which provides Uganda farmers with information about best practices in agriculture through their mobile phones, and the agents uses the application to help farmers determine the amount of seeds they need per acre of land. And this particular application, when you download as a farmer, you will see what you have grown. You can sell through the application, which is creating a bridge between the producers and the buyers.
The day was celebrated under the theme, Transforming Food Systems, Youth Innovation for Human and Planetary Health. Report by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news at Kololo.